still need to coach kids.
Yeah, well, that's what your blue belts are for.
So started grappling at the end of 2010 with my wrestling coach, Jan. Basically started wrestling and submission grappling at once with the main idea wanted to be an MMA fighter. So then we started the FILA comps beginning of 2011. So I live in Polokwane, so we need to travel to Joburg or Pretoria to get some fights or matches in. So at that stage it was only no-gi. So we get down here and then we only have like three or four fights, and to make the trip worth it, we're like, okay, let's buy some gis, or what's the suits these guys are wearing. So at end of 2011, I bought my first gi after a year of no-gi. And then, yeah, met Professor Jürgen Pitter, got promoted to blue belt in 2012. Started training with him for 2 years, 3 years. 2015, I met Rich at EFC, asked him, can I do a private? Because I saw leg locks was the new thing in 2015. And started training with him 2015 at a private. He completely smashed me, and then I was like, okay, there's some changes that needs to be made. And from 2015, I started training with him and Norman, and it's been 7 years now, and happy since. 2016, got promoted to purple belt. 2019, got my brown belt from Professor Richard Norman, and 3 years later, black belt's coming up. So it's been some journey. So when I just started, it was only on the wrestling competitions. They had two or three mats back in the day, 2011. They was called FILA grappling. It was mostly no-gi. So 2011 started. 2012, I won my division. 2012, I got SA colors in submission grappling. 2013, started doing gi. 2014 was the Hanami challenge. Entered on two divisions, won that. Won some local comps, didn't compete much international. Traveled internationally, Thailand, that's my special place. So just before COVID, that was December. So I traveled to Tiger Muay Thai, Phuket top team, and that was my December. Just step out of the comfort zone, keep training. And like I said, sometimes you think because you're from Africa, you doubt yourself in the beginning, like we're not on that level. But when you get there, when you see you can hang with these guys, you feel a lot better. And it just motivates you, like keep training, trust your coaches, what your coaches tells you works and shows you works. And that was, for me, it's keep active. Rather, I say it again, leave your ego. Even if you don't compete, go to other gyms. Put yourself out there regardless. Just keep on learning, and you can learn from everyone. As long as you stay on the mat, and everyone on the mat, everyone is the same. Regardless if you're a doctor, lawyer, electrician, mechanic, whatever. On the mat, everyone's the same. The more work you put in, the better you get. There's no secret. Everyone always asks, what's the secret? There's no secret. Keep training and you'll be good. So I met Rich in 2015. Him and Norman, they had a lot of EFC champs, and I still think to this day they had the most EFC champions. And that, I think that speaks for itself. So I met him at an EFC event, and leg locks just came out, and I was like, can I please do a private with you? We did the private for like 30 minutes, and then we rolled for 30 minutes, and that was the longest 30 minutes of my life. And I just realized that there's a change to be made for. I travel far, so it's 7 hours up and down for me to train for 1 hour. So make it worth it. And when I come here, the skill level that at the gym at QuanWessels is just, for me personally, it's very high. And I want to learn and I want to improve. The system they provide, the structure, and it's not just on the mat. It's you can be great off the mat, on the mat, and be an idiot off the mat. That's not how it works. For them, it's be good on the mat, be good off the mat. And what do you give back? Do you help people just on the mat, off the mat? So it's just not on the mats for them. It's a way of life. So how you carry yourself all around, and that's to me, that's what I learned from my dad. So it's, you can be great on the mat and an asshole off the mat, and that doesn't be good on and off the mat. Give back to the community, help everyone, and what they like I said, I'm lucky enough to know them on a personal level as well, and for me that means a lot. It's for me, I like stuff that's physical. I had two MMA fights. One, it wasn't really a fight, so I just took the guy down and I choked him, so it's not really a fight. The other one, I took a fight on 2 hours' notice. I was a lightweight and I fought a middleweight. He smashed me. So after that, I was like, no, this is not for me. The physical part, the mental part, like I said, regardless if you have a good day or a bad day, I always, you feel better after training. And the community, the friends I made in Jiu-Jitsu and on the mat is my friends today. I mean, Don, Laura, they're in Cape Town. I've got family here, Rich, Jess. I know them on a personal level. And for me, and I met them in Jiu-Jitsu. So Jiu-Jitsu completely saved my life or changed my life. And that's why I just keep on training. Stay on the mat.